There's a lot of parts inside a performance engine, but one of the parts that is not often given too much thought to is the thrust bearing. And in some instances, the thrust bearing might need a significant rethink in order to remain reliable. We're here with Christian from Nitto Performance Engineering to find out a little bit more about thrust bearings and what they've developed in order to fix certain problems. So let's start with the basics there, Christian. The thrust bearing in the engine, the part most people don't think about, what's it actually there for? Why do we need these?
So the thrust bearing is actually there to support the longitudinal force coming through the crankshaft moving forward. The actual roller thrust bearing, otherwise known as a Torrington bearing, has some rollers on it to support that force moving forward. What we've done to modify, what we've done to support that actual bearing is modify the front counterweight of the RB30 crankshaft. So this modification is currently only available on our RB30 cranks. We've given the Torrington thrust bearing a full 360 support all the way around in order to alleviate premature and uneven wear.
Okay, so if we take a step back and let's break this down into the basics. Conventionally, in a factory engine, yep, we don't use a roller thrust bearing. It's just a thrust washer, sort of with a similar construction to maybe a conventional main bearing, correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
So where are the limitations with these bearings? Why do they become problematic in certain applications?
It's mainly based around strength. So the roller thrust bearings or the Torrington bearings are far stronger and have a greater ability to support that longitudinal force.
Okay, now also you've used that term longitudinal force. And just to sort of clear that up, obviously we've got our main bearings that are supporting the crankshaft as it rotates. Mm-hmm. There is some vertical force in that as the combustion event takes place. We've got our connecting rod, big end bearings as well, which kind of do the same for our connecting rods. But those thrust bearings there, as you mentioned, longitudinally, they're there to support the crankshaft as it's forced forwards or sometimes backwards in the engine block. Yep. Now, in a road car, that's really around when the driver is engaging and disengaging the clutch. Mm-hmm. So there's a limited amount of force, I guess, being applied to that by the clutch. This gets increasingly larger when we start putting sort of higher clamping force clutches on. In a drag application like ZEUS behind me, which currently holds the world record for the fastest RB26, what is increasing that thrust loading? Why do we need that additional support?
So that additional support is required because just the different gearboxes that the cars use, so they don't use conventional gearboxes and running gear. They obviously use very, very high-end stuff, some of which I can't really talk about, obviously, but that is the main reason why we opt to go for the roller thrust as opposed to the conventional thrust bearing.
Okay, so let's talk about the parts you've developed to do this. You've already mentioned this is really only available for your RB30 crankshaft. What was the development process to include this roller thrust?
So the development process was actually pretty simple because we already have the initial design of the crankshaft. All we did was add some extra material to the front counterweight. We then 3D printed the front counterweight or the front, the first rod bearing section only, and then fitted it into a block, validated the design like that. And then from there, it was pretty well ready to go to manufacture.
Okay, so one side of this roller thrust washer essentially is running against this crankshaft surface. Yep. Fair to assume the other side of this is running against a conventional thrust surface on the block?
Yes.
Okay, at what point would someone need to start looking at this? And clearly, obviously, they need to be running one of your RB30 crankshafts anyway, but safe to say, street cars maybe not so necessary?
Yeah, street cars not so necessary. Obviously, there is some blurred lines between what's a street car and what's not nowadays. But if you're going to put a rough power figure on things, because that's the way a lot of people like to work, I would say around that 1500 horsepower, also dependent upon what transmission you're using, is when you want to start thinking about a roller thrust bearing.
Okay. Obviously, again, definitely not a product that's going to be suited to everyone, but if you are in that market, 1500 horsepower and up, obviously now Nitto do have a solution. If people want to find out more or purchase one of these crankshafts and the roller thrust, how are they best to do so?
Best way to go about that, we've got a comprehensive dealer network that we have listed on our website. Alternatively, you can contact us and we can put you onto a dealer that's near you.
Okay. Thanks for your time, Christian.
Thank you very much.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.